Hi peeps. So plane. You all kind of like the train, so I thought, okay, let's do a bit more transport. And we've got the plane, which is quite an easy pattern. So hopefully it's gonna suit lots of people. So of course I've printed out my pattern. I've put some parchment paper over the top of my pattern, so you can see through, so you can trace what you need to. I'm going to start smack bang in the middle with this nice red bit. So, going to start with the darkest piece first, which is this piece right at the front. Just trace around find your fabrics. I've pulled out a few reds. Obviously the darkest is this one, so that's what I'm going to use. I've just gone with my reds. I've just gone in values, so in tones, so gone palest, middle, slightly more middle, and at the end. So it was just light to dark, basically. And don't panic about values. I know some people understand it completely, other people are completely flummoxed by it. But if you look at the colour version of my picture, you can basically just follow what the colour is telling you to do. Some people use the grayscale. If they understand values, they can use the grayscale and they can do any colour they want to using that. But if you're not too sure, just follow the color version and try and get your fabrics close to what it says in the color version. So there we go. It's pretty close. It's just going to go straight on there. And then what I'm going to do, I think I'm going to cut out this white piece in here. And then I can stick under. And what I'm the next level down actually comprises of two, we've got a grey, light grey and a white. But I'm going to cut the circle out completely of white, I think. Maybe I should have started with the blue. Should we start with the blue? Do the blue bit. And then the white bit and then the red bit. That's probably the best way around. So let me just go and grab my blue drawer. See what we can find. Quite possibly, maybe perfect. That certainly is perfect. That's going to match that there. Ideally, I'd like to have something that's got a bit of a pattern on just next to it. So we'll keep having a little hunt through. See if I can make that work. It's maybe a bit too white. Because the next colour is white as well. It's not quite the right colour. Think we should get away with that. Right. You don't want that one. Use those two. But again, I'm going to cut the circle out of one piece and then put another piece on the top of it. And I'm going to draw it in so I can then cut it out again. I haven't got much fusible on there. Now somewhere I've got here, here we go. Got a few scraggy bits we can stick on there to make it a bit bigger. Find my circle again. Make sure I'm using the bit that has got fusible on. Got a bit cocky this time and I haven't checked that the microphone's working, so cross your fingers. Because it's worked the last few times, I didn't check this time, which was probably a bit stupid. Right. So that's going to go in the middle, and I go back to this one and try and work out which bit I need to cut out, and it's to look at the picture again. So it's the bottom bit. I'm just going to find which bit I want here, I think. Right, so that's going to go on there. Oops. Not sure that's got any fusible on it. Find another scrap. Cut it out again. And glue that down again. It's not coming off terribly easy. Ta-da! Right, now what I'm going to do is, it's not got, you probably can't see quite because it's a bit far away, but it's not got the best edge. It's got a bit sticking out. Can you see that? So I'm just going to go around that circle. Just curl that top up as well. It's not good. It's all right. There it comes out. Because it's a circle, you do want it to be kind of to be fairly precise. So that's much better. Okay. So now I'm going to do the white. And because we now got the brew bit in, I'm not going to do a whole bit of white. I'm going to do as it shows. So I'm going to cut around like that. But I've got to go and get some white. Now the question is, do I use a little pattern? Which is quite nice. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to use this little pattern. Move this across a bit. Realise this is right on the edge. What you can see, it's better, isn't it? Just cutting it slightly bigger, because that's going to tuck underneath. In the end, I haven't managed to get much of the pattern on there at all, but there's a little bit. Okay, so now I want grey. Just a pale grey. That'll do fine. There you go. If you struggle to cut out this sort of thing, then you can always turn it over and stick it on the back. It's often an easier way to do if it's more, a bit more stable in your hands because it's stuck down. Circles are a bit tricky to cut around. Keep them as a circle. It does not want to go on there. So it's going to go in there. So all of this is going to come up. I'm just going to put this down first. Stick this on the top. Right. So now we can do the red bits. So onto the red bits now. So we've done the dark piece, so we want the next darkest piece that I've got, which is that piece, I think. Let me just make sure. Got in a bit of a mess. Yes. So those are my four reds. So you can clearly see that's the darkest bit. That's going to go next. That's going to go next. And then I'm going to use that as the lightest piece. Okay. So I want the next darkest piece, which is that piece. I don't want too much of an overlap because I'm worried that it will show through the white. Obviously it does need to overlap a bit, but not too much. I don't know what I'm doing. I've already cut this out and put it down and I've forgotten how to cut it out. I did have a bit of a deja vu moment. Bring the camera down a bit. Okay, that's not very circular, so I'm just going to trim that off. Better. And then I want the palest. No, I won't. I'll go over here and do this bit, and then I'm all in order. So we're going to go actually looking at this, I'm one colour short, so I need to go. No, I don't. So that's going to come in here. It's going to be this one. Okay. And then we're going to go playlist. This is quite a tricky one to cut out because it's quite thin, so I'm going to stick it on the other side. So what I need to do is make sure that I turn it over. Just make sure that that fits nicely. Yeah, because this piece I'm going to put on the top rather than going under. Purely because I haven't left enough gap at the top there. So I can just use this. Kind of realign it all. There we go. So that bit's done. So I'm going to go and do, what's it called, propeller. Pretty easy. Draw both bits on. On this side I've got dark, light, medium. So I need three browns. This side I've just got a dark and a medium. So let's see what we got. Got this, which is quite nice for the dark. Maybe this for them. Oh, actually. So dark, medium, light. Yeah, they work nicely together. So let's think about this. So I need the dark and the medium for this top propeller. So dark first. I don't want anything too dark, you know, I don't want it to dominate too much. More than dark enough. So that will go on like that. Don't need to cut that edge out because I'm going to stick it under. Okay, it's one done. So this one here is the darkest one. Then we have the medium one and then a lighter one. So we'll start again with the dark one, and then everything can tuck underneath that. The medium could have maybe gone a little bit lighter with the medium, but kind of got to use what you got at the end of the day. Cut the wrong bit there. Have I? Yes, I need this bit in the middle. Slim bits can be a bit tricky to cut. So I know it's going straight down, so I'm just going to cut it straight down. Gap in there, don't want that. Right, so I'm going to redraw this one because I feel like I've cut mine a little bit on the slim side. Ideally, I'm going to put another piece in here, so I haven't really gone, haven't really made that quite big enough. It's not a problem. Maybe even put another darker piece in. just fix that in, and then just got a bit that wants to stick up on this side, on the wrong side. There we go. Yeah, so I'm going to just put another little piece in as well, because I didn't really quite cut it deep enough. I don't want to use that because that's a bit too grey. Just use a slither of that. I think that's a bit weak drawing. Yeah. Very good idea, isn't it? Fix that at the bottom and then just coax this out a little bit at the top. That's it, that's where I want it. And I'm just going to fill the whole lot up and just round this off a little more. There we go. Okay, so there we go. We've made a really good start. I'm going to stop there. I'm going to probably go and do my bullseyes on this side and this side, because we've obviously done that kind of thing there. And then we'll come back probably to the main body of the plane. So bye for now.